Thank you for choosing Shifting Grades. Kindly subscribe to Shifting Grades and share the link. I want us to look at the calculation of the height of a mountain by considering differences in atmospheric pressure at the different levels of the mountain. It is very evident that we said due to the weight of the air above the surface of the earth, the air exerts pressure on the earth's surface. I didn't mention this, that the pressure differs depending on the altitude of a place, depending. For instance, assuming that the atmosphere is ranging from a place there above, then we got the earth's surface, which has plateaus, mountains, and valleys. We find that pressure at the mountain is having a smaller height than pressure at the bottom of the mountains or at valleys. So at the valleys, you find the column of air is too high. The column of air is too high, such that atmospheric pressure is highest in valleys, but lowest in highlands. Because in highlands, from the atmosphere to the mountain top, we got a small column of air. Therefore, since atmospheric pressure differs depending on the heights of places or the altitude of places, then we can calculate height of mountains, and we can take an example like in the following. You're told the barometric height is 65 centimeters of mercury at the top of a mountain, and 75 centimeters of mercury at the bottom. Then we are given that density of mercury as 13,600, and that of air as 1.25 kilograms per meter cubed. Also, this one for mercury, 13,600 kilograms per meter cubed. Therefore, we can see here at the top of a mountain, at the top, barometric height is 65 centimeters of mercury, and at the bottom, 75 centimeters of mercury. As I had said, pressure at the top should be lower than at the bottom, since a bigger height than at the top, a bigger height of air. Therefore, now it is good to know that there is an air column which is making all this difference. And the air column resulting to the difference is the air column between the top and the bottom. The top and the bottom. Therefore, the pressure due to this air column is bringing out the difference in pressure at the top and at the bottom. Therefore, we can take the difference between the bottom and the top. Then we say that pressure is due to the air column on the mountain side, on the mountain. Therefore, we can say pressure difference is equal to pressure of air column, pressure of the air column. And that will make us calculate the pressure difference by taking pressure at the bottom minus pressure at the top. Therefore, pressure at the bottom minus pressure at the top will give us pressure of air, pressure of air. Therefore, at the top, at the bottom, we'll have, because mercury is a liquid, we'll have 75, which are centimeters, so we divide by 100, divide by 13, 600, and we multiply by 10. Then we add, okay, we subtract, sorry, pressure difference, 65, divide by 100, we multiply by 13, 600, times 10. So the pressure difference, will be multiplied by 13,600 times 10. So the pressure difference will be 13,600 Pascal. This pressure difference is due to the air column, and if it is due to the air column, then we can equate it to the pressure of the air column, and the air column is having a height unknown times 1.25, which is the density of air, times 10. Therefore, the height of the mountain will be given by, when we divide this pressure with 1.25 times 10, and this will give us 1,088 meters. Therefore, the height of air column will be 1,088 meters, which is the height of the mountain. The height of the mountain, since it is that air column bringing out a pressure difference. So thank you for following. Kindly continue subscribing to the channel Shifting Grades.